Hey guys,
one of them is a manatee.
One of them is named Bupis.
Yes, one of them is. Lobs up there, a couple belugas.
Hey guys, welcome to a new Big Shark Gaming podcast. I'm Joe, and that blotch. Which that way? That way. Oh, that was easy. You're this way.
What side am I going to be on the camera?
On camera, you're on the right side.
Okay.
I'm on the left side, and underneath me down there is a Big Shark Gaming logo.
For me, it's just you, and I'm in a little box in the corner.
So you can't even see yourself. I actually have the advantage of seeing myself, because, you know.
I can very barely see myself. Like, when you see me get all close like this, that's me looking into my little box.
Why would you be looking at your little box, though?
To see what the crowd sees.
Oh. Yeah, guys, as you probably have noticed by now, this is the first time that Jay and I are doing a podcast since I moved from the city and living with Jay, my brother, so it's not creepy. But, yeah, so we're still trying to work out the kinks. We're trying to do new things here at Big Shark Gaming.
Indeed, work out the kinks.
It's so funny that I'm wearing a New York Knicks shirt, right? Considering all things that are going on with the New York Knicks right now. Are you wearing a Jettigon shirt? Yeah, you are. Do you still wear the Pandora Corn shirt that I got you?
Yes, every now and then.
Oh, every now and then. Guess what I'm going to do? The Game Grumps shirt that you got me, I'm going to wear every now and then. This video, sponsored by Candy Club. If you want to save $15 on your next Candy Club order, use the code YouTube15 on checkout, and $15 will automatically be deducted from your box.
Jay, yeah.
What are you doing?
Mom.
All right, so before.
She was like, Howard!
Howard! Yeah, before we got started recording, you were talking about some YouTube kidnapping.
Oh, there go my headphones. I can't hear you.
Can you really not hear me?
What?
yeah, but before we started this podcast, we were talking about how you...
I don't know what you're talking about. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this.
Oh, that's your wrinkled dick again. Yeah, you were talking about how someone got kidnapped on YouTube. Tell the story.
I don't remember all the details, but it was a video of stereotypical nerd. Get that in your brain. He was talking about how he got some girlfriend, blah, blah, blah. He doesn't go on camera a lot, blah, blah, blah. I'll try to get her to come on camera for you. And he opens the door to this bathroom, and you see this girl screaming for help, and then the video just ends like that.
Yeah, because this conversation... This conversation got brought up because... As you see this door here, that's the door to mine and Kelly's bathroom. In every video where I have a face cam, I normally cut it off like right here because I don't feel like all that stuff is necessary to see. And yes, I know I have fat hands. That's the only thing about me that's fat. But this door here is always closed. Because the bathroom is there. And I don't know, I feel like it's proper etiquette to have the bathroom door closed. As you've probably noticed, right here is the opening to our living room. And, you know, our living room is pretty big. Like, look, it's, like, pretty big around. Like, but, Jesus, that hallway light is just killer. But yeah, you know, our living room is pretty big, but we don't have a door on it. So, it's kind of, weird that you guys could look right into the bathroom, and I feel like it's proper etiquette just to have the bathroom door closed. And also, it's always there's always gonna be glare on my glasses. Kelly makes fun of that all the time because of the fact that I'm looking right at the computer screen, so the computer screen is reflecting back. And I have like a lamp right here, just for like recording purposes. That's like the bedroom lamp that I just move out here to record. I also have a shark right here. I have a bowl right here, and I'll tell you why, Jay. So today, I went out and I bought this little gadget, right? You know what this is?
It looks like a phone stand.
Like a what?
It looks like a phone stand.
Yeah, it's a car mount for your phone. So I can use this to record things like Pokemon TCG openings like I uploaded earlier today. Well, yesterday, because this video is going to go up tomorrow. Yeah, that one didn't really...
I also have one.
Yeah, that one doesn't really work too well. If I recall, but I bought this and I put my phone on it right after I got home and I put it on the desk. I, you know, locked it in so this way it won't fall over. And then I went to the kitchen, I came back and I heard a loud pop. I was like, fuck, that was the car mount. I came in and my phone and the car mount were halfway across the fucking living room. So then, I locked it back on. I was like, oh, maybe I just didn't do it right. So I locked it back on, in the middle of recording something, boop, popped right back off. So I realized, I was like, man, it's probably just not suctioning to the wood good. Quote that. It's probably just not, you know, locking onto the wood good enough. So I brought over, like, this glass bowl, and I locked it on, and that was good enough. And it got stuck. Oh, shit, it's stuck right now.
I imagine it's a lot like a suction cup.
Well, it is a suction cup, you see? But it has, like, this lock on it where you, like, lock it down.
So something like wood that's more polished probably won't be able to...
Well, it's not really polished wood. It's, like, really kind of, like, pressed board.
Well, you probably need, like, something like glass or something ceramic.
Yeah, that's why I got the glass bowl. And it worked out much better, as you probably have seen already in the TCG video. Where I got, fuck, you want to see what my rare was, Jay? I don't know if you've seen the video yet. You want to see what my rare was?
No, I haven't yet. Oh, a pretty butterfly.
Fucking bullshit. But yeah, I bought another pack. For those of you who are watching for the first time, here's your code for a free pack on TCGO. And spoilers, I got reverse rare switch. The reverses now, I'll try it, are really cool. You see like how they have like this, like, I guess that's a Pokeball, right? Yeah, it's a Pokeball, and a bunch of small Pokeballs. But that was my reverse rare, and my rare was a fucking regular rare Butterfree. So that made me kind of angry. But I still have two more packs to open. We're going to do that later when Kelly gets home. And I have, oh shit. Sorry, guys. This.
Box!
Yeah, I got a box. I'm trying to not, there we go.
So does it have a giant card in there?
Yeah, it has a giant card. So Kelly has gotten into collecting giant cards. Here, let me show you the collection she's got. I'll turn off this hallway light as well. But yeah, so... She's really gotten into collecting giant Pokemon cards. And she thinks they're hilarious. But, so she's got Arcanine Break from the Arcanine Break box. She's got Tyrantrum Break from the Tyrantrum EX Break box. Snorlax GX from the Snorlax GX box. And then finally...
Is that Snorlax using a Z-move?
What?
Using its Z move?
Yeah. All GXs all have like one GX attack. And I guess if like they have like an actual Z crystal, they'll have like their signature move. But so far,
that's cool.
I think that Snorlax is the only one that actually had a Z move that's been made into a GX card so far. And then finally she has Kangaskhan. Unfortunately for this Kangaskhan, and credit to the material of these cards, because they're more like plastic than they are paper.
Sturdy.
Yeah, they're real sturdy, And the other day, I spilled ginger ale on it. And it, there's no damage to the car. It's a little bit sticky in some spots, but yeah, she wasn't.
Oh, that's pretty good.
She wasn't too happy that I spilled ginger ale on her car. So, and now today I got this at TJ Maxx. Guys, if you go to TJ Maxx, they actually have these. I spent 15, I think, on it. 15. And they have a bunch of Dragonite boxes. Unfortunately, TJ Maxx's website is fucking stupid. Where, like, you cannot search by brand. So, you can't go on TJ Maxx and search Pokemon. Because it would be like, sorry, we can't search for brands. And there's no way to look at their website and search for Pokemon cards. So, you're just going to have to walk into the store. I don't know if it's in other, like...
What happens if you just search for cards?
I mean, we could try right now. Hold on. Let's see. I'll do it right on the podcast right now. New tab. So I'm gonna move it over your face for a second, alright? So here we go. We're gonna TJ Maxx. As you see, we're uploading a video. I know when they rang it up, it came up as like toys and books or something. So what did you want me to search, Shay?
Card.
Card?
Just like search for cards. Yeah.
All right, so we're going to search for cards. Let's make this a little bit smaller, this window. This way it fits in a little bit better. No, it actually comes with, like, card cases, purses. Let's see if we could go into... Let's see what other sections they have here. Yeah, they have clearance home, men, jewels and accessories, handbags, shoes, women, and new arrivals. Let's see if we go to category, if something comes up. No, you can't even, like... They have, like, genuinely the worst website I've ever seen. You can't search for anything. And, like, obviously it wouldn't be a men. What, accessories, maybe? No, not even. So, yeah, you can't... It's bizarre. Really, I don't fucking get it. So, Jason, I was texting Mom earlier, and it's funny to say how I am now 26 years old, right? Which means I've probably been playing video games for probably, like, 23 years, right? Which is longer than you've been alive. But, guess... Four games that I'm playing right now.
Final Fantasy.
Yep, one. Final Fantasy 15.
Have you started Dragon Quest yet?
Yeah. Dragon Quest 8.
Okay, so Dragon Quest 8. Pokemon Moon.
Yep.
And... The fourth one.
I streamed it just yesterday.
Oh, Digimon.
Yep.
All stuff you played growing up.
I'm playing Final Fantasy 15, Dragon Quest 8, Pokemon Moon, which came out 4 months ago already, and Digimon.
Wow. I'm playing Pokemon Sun right now.
Yeah, I'm playing and Pokemon... Oh, look at that, Delph. Oh, you're beating up a
right
fucking
now.
Preschooler. But yeah, no, so...
Yeah, that's not Rantrum.
Yeah, so do I. Right here. But yeah, so... Four games that I am playing that I played my entire life. I started my first Final Fantasy game, Final Fantasy VII. First Pokemon game was Pokemon Red. Digimon was Digimon World, and Dragon Quest was Dragon Warrior 3. Yep, Dragon Warrior 3. The first Dragon Quest game I saw was Dragon Warrior Monsters when I saw Mario playing it. And that's what got me hooked into
Mario.
It. Because this is probably like before your time, but Mario used to have the Game Gear, and
I know. I heard stories about.
He used to play it.
Mario had.
Yeah, he used to play Dragon Quest Monsters on his TV, and I would just go over and watch him play that shit.
Oh, the Super Game Boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Super Game Boy, right?
Yeah.
I remember playing Donkey Kong on it.
But yeah, I mean, and that's what got me hooked on that shit. And it's so funny to see that, like, Pokemon 20.
Years later, here we are.
Pokemon's 20. Final Fantasy 30. Dragon Quest 30. Dragon Quest Monsters Joker is 10 years old as it is. And
yeah,
Digimon's 15. Digimon's the youngest of the group. And youngest by 5 years. Because Pokemon's 5 years older than Digimon. 5 years.
Yeah, everything we grew up with is turning 20 now.
Yeah, it's crazy. Something. It's crazy to see how, like, you just don't realize things age. Not just you, like, that Pac-Man wall in your room's gotta be, like, 18 years old.
Yeah, me and Mom were talking about it just the other day.
Like,
Kirby had his 25th anniversary. Now, Kirby had his 20th anniversary, like...
2 years ago. To put it in perspective, I think the PlayStation 3 just turned 10 years old.
How old is the Xbox?
Let's look that up.
The 360.
I'm going to put this over your face again. So, Xbox 360.
I know Soul Calibur 5 is from 2009.
Yeah, I think the Xbox... I honestly think the Xbox 360 dates back to 2014. But let's just search Xbox 360 release date. November 22nd, 2005. So I was a year off. I said 2004. But yeah, Xbox will be 12 years old today. I mean, this year. And that is the Xbox 360, not even the Xbox One. So let's see the PS3 release date. It was November 11th, 2006. So it just turned 10 years.
The 3DS came out in 2011.
Yeah.
And I still have my original one.
When did the Nintendo DS come out?
2001?
2004. So the DS isn't really that old.
It's old.
Yeah, I mean, it's
13 years.
It will. They all come out on November, like November 20th around there, which is weird that like
for the holiday.
Yeah, it's true. That's a good point. That's usually right before Black Friday.
Right, and Christmas is not that far after that.
Yeah. It's weird to see that the Switch is coming out the 3rd of March, which is only a few days away.
I feel like the reason why the Switch is coming out at some seemingly random date is because of how much hype it has.
It does. It has a lot of hype. Did you see that they already have 60 titles?
Yes, I did.
And these titles include like a Fire Emblem title, a Shin Megami Tensei. What?
People have been crying for Nintendo to get third-party support, and now they finally have it, and people are even realizing exactly what that means.
Yeah, they don't realize how many titles are going to be on the Switch. And people are already saying, oh, well, the Switch is weaker than the PS4. It's not supposed to be...
Yeah, but you can't take the PS... You can't take the PS4 out of your house.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. The Switch is a like hybrid console. It is a portable console. It's an at-home console.
Did you hear what NIS America... said about the Switch?
Our buddies
in
America.
In regards to Disgaea 5.
Yeah, they want to...
They said...
Go ahead.
They were like... Disgaea 5 for the Switch was a no-brainer. Because if we had to port it to the Vita, we would have to cut some stuff back. We don't have to do that with the Switch.
Yeah. And... there's a lot of stuff coming over to the Switch. And the Switch is just as powerful as the Xbox One. And to be fair...
It has to be.
To be fair...
If you could squeeze all of the Disgaea 5 onto the Switch, it must be pretty strong. If you could squeeze all of
Skyrim
onto the Switch...
NBA...
It must be good.
Splatoon 2 is going to be amazing. Breath of Wild looks amazing. And I know it's like Zelda Dark Souls, but like still.
Isn't that what people want?
Yeah, it's exactly what people want. And
it's Zelda going back to its roots where you could pretty much just go. You could beat the game in 15 minutes.
Yeah, you could go beat Zelda Breath of Wild in 15 minutes if you chose to. But it's not. I said this in a previous video that like it's not about beating the game. It's about
going on the journey.
Yeah, it's about the adventure of it.
Just like the original Zelda was.
Yeah.
In Zelda 1, if you go straight for Ganon, you could beat the game in like half an hour.
Yeah. Or like Zelda 2, where it's like, come on, this isn't like fucking Faces of Evil or like Gamelon, where it takes you 17 years just to figure out the controls. So, to be fair, the only system that's going to be more powerful than the PS4 right now is the PS4 Pro, which got a huge update recently.
Which, that's the point.
Yeah, that's the point. The PS4 Pro is supposed to be, like, kind of that bridging system.
A better PS4.
Yes, it's supposed to be the bridge between the PS4 and the eventual PS5, which I don't see the PlayStation 5 coming out for another.
What's going on?
Weapon?
Are we seriously up to PlayStation 5 already?
Yeah.
We're up to PlayStation 5.
Well, we're not up to PlayStation 5. I don't think the PlayStation 5 is even going to be revealed for another 7 or 8 years, to be honest. The PS4 is so strong.
Can we think about that?
I don't think we should.
What happens when we get to Final Fantasy 20?
Who knows? I honestly don't know what they can do with Final Fantasy at this point. In terms of graphic-wise, because 15 looks beautiful.
I feel like that's the problem. Because only get so good.
Yeah, because a lot of these games. Go ahead.
Limit how good graphics could be because we're trying to compare them to real life. Graphics.
Yep.
Become one-to-one real life, can it improve?
I wouldn't say that they're one-to-one real life. I wouldn't go as far as saying that. But I would definitely put the graphics of Final Fantasy 15 at maybe like 1-3. It looks...
Which is still
stupid ridiculous. To think that like Final Fantasy 7...
Be able to smell the great mighty foo.
Good. To think that like we came from Final Fantasy VII, where people looked like fucking Legos, to Final Fantasy XV, a game that was in development for 11 years, using technology 11 years old, and it looks so realistic. I remember when I first cut the first trailer for an unnamed Final Fantasy game, when they revealed the PS4 and the Unreal Engine, and it was like almost a live action movie. And Final Fantasy 15 is almost live action.
He looked good.
It's like...
Like, 3 hit that live action look.
And I feel like now, a lot of video game developers are kind of cashing in on the cartoony look. Like, things like Star Ocean or, like, the Tales series are like, hey, we're not trying to look realistic because we want to go off the nostalgia, this is cartoony feel. Where, like, things like...
I feel like that makes games last longer, honestly.
Yeah.
The more you distance yourself from the real world, the longer you're Wind Waker.
I think it works both ways, to be honest. Where people are just like, man, we want to be cartoony and we want to be like old school and people are going to buy that because it's old school and they don't feel like being so submersed in this like super realistic, hyper realistic world. But at the same time, I feel people are just like, man, I want to play a game and just play it and appreciate the beauty of it. Like, I can turn on Final Fantasy 15 and do nothing but ride my chocobo for 30 minutes, not even get into a single fight, and just appreciate the world of it. And... I'm sure Chocobo Bullet's legs are so tired afterwards, but sorry, bro. And then there's like Digimon Next World Order, which what?
A song from 13.
Oh. But yeah, like, yeah, even though I go back and look at Final Fantasy 13, which 15 is part of that saga.
Already.
Yeah, even look at that saga and try and compare them, it's not comparable. And like, I wonder if like they're gonna continue the whole every three Final Fantasies is gonna be an online game trend that they have, which would put 17 at an online game. But
Final Fantasy 20 is on. It's an MMO confirmed.
I cannot think of Final Fantasy 16. I can't. I can't see any Final Fantasies besides like side stories like Type Zero coming out. But I can see Type Zero 2, which by the way it's Type Zero HD, so sorry for all like the Metacritics out there who are gonna like rampage and go crazy because I said Type Zero and not Type Zero HD. But I can see Type Zero HD.
Can you see my eyes roll?
Yeah. I could see a second game of that coming out before I see Final Fantasy 16 coming out. I could see another Crystals. And they're trying to milk it. They're putting out World of Final Fantasy, Final Fantasy Explorers, which I can see Final Fantasy Explorers 2 coming out on Switch.
Fantasy Explorer.
And, man, I want Fantasy Life 2 already.
It's out in Japan.
Yeah, but it's a mobile device game. It's like a free-to-play. Let's pull up that Google Chrome again. I'll cover my face this time.
No, my face!
No, I'll cover my face this time. Whoa, what is going on? I grabbed the tab by accident. Oh, I can't cover my face because I'm always on top. all right, so let's... Fantasy Life 2. Fantasy Life 2, renamed Fantasy Life Online. There's trailers for it. Says Fantasy Life 2 game promo reveals that the game will release soon. This was from July 29th, 2016. It's for iOS and Android devices. In addition, Level 5 announced during the presentation of the game will have a closed beta beginning on Friday. But this doesn't show anything. Said Level 5 confirmed via press conference on Wednesday that there is no plan to release the game outside of Japan as of yet. So, possibility that we won't get Fantasy Life 2. But if they renamed it Fantasy Life Online, they might be working on a Fantasy Life 2 title, to be fair.
Yeah, maybe.
Which Fantasy Life was great. If you guys haven't played Fantasy Life, I definitely recommend checking it out. And don't play it with Jay because.
Hate it again.
What?
We should play it again.
Yeah, we should. We should. It's just I like. We got so strong.
We gotta get the DLC.
Yeah, we do.
100 super bosses.
Yeah, I mean, I still have to go back and get the Joyous sword. I just gotta like do a few more things to be able to get it. I get to be like a level master level blacksmith,
master warrior, master blacksmith, and master carpenter. Maybe
I think carpenter is the last one, or miner. I think it's miner. I think I just need to finish miner, and that's it.
The name of the wand was. For me, but in order to get the wand, I needed to be Master Wizard, Master Alchemist, and Master Chef.
Chef.
Things is not like the other.
Ugh.
Master Chef.
Master Chef, yeah, we're allowed to say that without, like, Gordon Ramsay be like, you fucking asshole! You fucking come out here, you make fun of my chef! Oh, come blind me!
There's no genre!
So, Jay, you said you've been working on some things for the channel. What have you been working on?
I've been recording Pokemon videos.
Is that it?
Pretty much.
Did you get the website I sent you earlier? Don't say the name of the website, just say yes or no. Jay's frozen. Jason?
You're breaking up.
Jason! Sorry, guys. Some technical difficulties on Jason's end. And also a reference to Heavy Rain. Heavy Mole. Oh, well, look at that. Try to get Jay back on. Oh, there's the rest of my face. So we'll go back to Google Hangout. Try to get Jay back on the horn. Hi, Big, because I'm Big. See if we can get him back here. I wonder what happened. Okay. Call him back. Get him back up in here. Hello. Welcome back. You there?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can't see you, but I can hear you. Ah! Humble Hump!
Hello.
Sup?
I have taken over this channel.
You motherfucker!
Who is talking? I cannot see you.
I am a Thark!
Prove it.
My real identity! And you keep fucking around. You know what that means? Yeah? Minus 1,000 points!
I'm back.
Bye, Trevor.
Hi!
So, upcoming on the channel, and we'll wrap it up after this, but upcoming on the channel, I'm going to be working on a few little short skits. I've always wanted to do something like this. Obviously, the Treventures are short skits, and I have fun with those, but I want to take that a little bit further. I've been working on two different, and hear me out on this, let me finish, two different raps. One is
blasphemy.
One is a Pokemon abilities rap, and one is a rap using the several voice acting things I do. It's kind of like gonna be a showcase of my voice acting abilities, as well as like just something so fucking stupid. And I wanted to get back into art lately, and I don't mean just like drawing and stuff. I meant more like musical art and like theater arts and theatrics. And I'm not really going to have all the time in the world, to be fair. Jay, you making fun of me right now? Yeah, fuck you, Jay. But yeah, so that's what I'm working on.
You gotta have discipline. You gotta have respect for your director.
That's wrong, and you know it. Sorry, I just wanted to quote Digimon World Next Order. What are you doing? You're off screen. You're, if you stay like that, all you can see is, like, the little blue in your headphone, and, like, the puff of your hair, and it looks like an evil eyeball. Are you scratching the microphone? What are you doing? Oh, squishy turtle. Milton's old toy. Yeah, so I'm going to be working on stuff like that. I don't know what Jay is working on, to be honest. I know he's going to have more Pokemon videos up. He's getting my tablet. He was supposed to get it today. But for some reason, the mail delayed, and he should probably get it Monday. Unless, for some reason, it ships tomorrow. I know it's tomorrow Sunday, but sometimes there is mail on Sundays. I know they don't process mail on Sundays, but I feel like if there's stuff that needs to go out, they will get it out. But he should probably get it Monday, which means that he will probably be able to do more video-wise. Also, what the fuck is that now? Jay, you're just acting weird. Is that a puppy? Why are you strangling the poor thing? Jay, once you get the tablet, I'm going to send you a program that I use to do all like my recordings. This way you could do like mirroring and stuff to your computer. And you could record like that. You could record straight through the program, so you don't need to really like use anything else. It's a pretty awesome program.
Is there any way I could use that to record off of my TV?
Not really. I think the best bet for you would just be like get a capture card. But you might need to get a better computer at some point, because that computer you have is ancient. I'm going to be...
The computer from Dell...
Jay, I don't even think that computer would be able to fucking run game capture. Like, what is that? Like a fucking 512 megabyte computer? What is Dell? What is this Dell you speak of? Is this the 90s? If I look outside, is gas going to be 97 cents a gallon? Airplane tickets are 40 bucks? Is that the Dell? Yeah, that thing. I know you can barely see on Jay's end, but that computer is from like 1995. That computer's probably as old as Jay is, and he's just held on to it to play fucking Roller Coaster Tycoon and fucking Zoo Tycoon and whatever else.
And Dragon Warrior Monsters.
Dragon Warrior Monsters, yeah, where a lake was invented. But I am going to be playing another game that
yes,
I got.
Because I'm never gonna have him again.
Yeah, I'm gonna be playing.
I'm gonna put him in another game.
I'm gonna be playing Sims 4 again, and not get banned this time. What? Oh no, I'm gonna play legit this time. I'm not gonna make a penis house. I'm not gonna get banned again.
Define legit.
I'm just gonna be playing. No cheats. No, nothing like that. Just for fun, and I hope you guys like it because I think it's gonna be hilarious. We're gonna be doing more pack openings of Pokemon and on TCGO and regular TCG. Splatoon. Jay is so weird, guys. I've had to deal with this for 21 years.
No, 20. You moved out a year ago.
I moved out almost 2 years ago. I've been in this apartment for almost a year. For over a year.
I know, it's been a year since you visited us.
I know, I just haven't had...
Such drama.
My drama. I've just been really busy, Jay, and you know that. It's been how long since you visited me?
If you come any closer, you'll fall through my computer screen.
It's been how long did you visit us?
When?
Well, we both took them away at the same time. Yeah, I just want to thank you guys for all of the support, and we're trying to do new things. We don't want to stay at 85 subscribers forever, so it's time for us to move on and adapt. I'm going to be doing more reviews for shows and TV and stuff. And Jay's over there frozen. I'm going to be doing more reviews for TV and movies and stuff. I'm going to do more food challenges because I want to. And we never did this year for the Reese's Cup. We were going to, and then they were fucking sold out. I couldn't find them anywhere. And also, more video games, more live streams, less of Jay doing weird shit like this. More Pokemon Corner, more TCG, more giveaways.
It's on.
If you comment,
No Moon.
Fuck off, Jay. If you comment, fuck off, Jay, in the comment section down below, you will win one of the three shiny legendary dogs. Raikou, Suikin, and Entei are all available still. Yeah, comment fuck off Jay in the comment section down below. The first one to do so will have their choice of one of the legendary shiny GameStop dogs. We still have a lot to give away, so definitely get on that. I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'm Joe from Big Shark Gaming.
Oh no, I clicked away.
And that's, oh no, I clicked away from game Big Shark Gaming. I want to thank you, Jay, for joining me, even though you've been like a black blotch the whole time.
All right, for watching this.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. This is a much lighter mood.
Never high def, never.
Yeah, you were never in high def. You weren't even high def in the womb.
Oh, really?
No, you never made it to high definition. You came out at like... 240p, maybe?
I was born without a face.
You weren't born without a face, Jay.
I was born in 8-bit.
Jay was born in 8-bit. He was born 3 months premature at 1 pound, 6 ounces. He was supposed to be born in November.
Pixels are very light.
I wonder if you were born in November, if you would have been born the same day as Kelly.
Maybe.
Gotta ask Mom what your original due date was. But yeah. Oh, thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye, Jay.
Bye, Joe. Bye, Sharks.
Bye, Sharkies.